have elaborated with knowledge as a guidance and mercy for a people who have faith.
Do they await anything but its fulfillment? The day when its fulfillment comes, those who had forgotten it before will say, Our Lord's apostles had certainly brought the truth, if only we had some intercessors to intercede for us, or we would be returned, so that we may do differently from what we did. They have certainly ruined their souls, and what they used to fabricate has forsaken them.
Indeed, your Lord is Allah who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days and then settled on the throne. He draws the night's cover over the day, which pursues it swiftly. And He created the sun, the moon, and the stars, all of them disposed by His command. Look, all creation and command belong to Him. Blessed is Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. Supplicate your Lord beseechingly and secretly. Indeed, He does not like the transgressors. And do not cause corruption on the earth after its restoration, and supplicate Him with fear and hope. Indeed, Allah's mercy is close to the virtuous. It is He who sends forth the winds as harbingers of His mercy. When they bear rain-laden clouds, we drive them toward a dead land, and send down water on it, and with it we bring forth all kinds of crops. Thus shall we raise the dead, maybe you will take admonition. The good land, its vegetation comes out by the permission of its Lord, and as for that which is bad, it does not come out except sparsely. Thus do we paraphrase the signs variously for a people who give thanks. Certainly we sent Noah to his people. He said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God besides Him. Indeed, I fear for you the punishment of a tremendous day. The elite of his people said, Indeed, we see you in manifest error. He said, O my people, I am not in error. Rather, I am an apostle from the Lord of all the worlds. I communicate to you the messages of my Lord, and I am your well-wisher, and I know from Allah what you do not know. Do you consider it odd that a reminder from your Lord should come to you through a man from among yourselves to warn you so that you may be God-wary and so that you may receive His mercy? But they denied Him. So we delivered him and those who were with him in the ark, and we drowned those who denied our signs. Indeed, they were a blind lot. And to the people of Ad, Hud, their brother, he said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God besides Him. Will you not then be wary of Him? The elite of His people who were faithless said, Indeed we see you to be in folly, and indeed we consider you to be a liar. He said, O my people, I am not in folly. Rather, I am an apostle from the Lord of all the worlds. I communicate to you the messages of my Lord, and I am a trustworthy well-wisher for you. Do you consider it odd that there should come to you a reminder from your Lord through a man from among yourselves, so that he may warn you? Remember when he made you successors after the people of Noah, and increased you vastly in creation. So remember Allah's bounties, so that you may be felicitous. They said, Have you come to tell us that we should worship Allah alone, and abandon what our fathers have been worshipping? Then bring us what you threaten us with, should you be truthful. He said, There has become due against you a punishment and wrath from your Lord. Do you dispute with me regarding names which you have named you and your fathers, for which Allah has not sent down any authority? So wait, I too am waiting along with you. Then we delivered him and those who were with him by a mercy from us, and we rooted out those who denied our signs and were not faithful. And to the people of Thamud, Saleh, their brother, he said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God besides Him. There has certainly come to you a manifest proof from your Lord. This she-camel of Allah is a sign for you. Let her alone to graze freely in Allah's land, and do not cause her any harm, for then you shall be seized by a painful punishment. Remember when He made you successors after the people of Ad and settled you in the land. You build palaces in its plains and hew houses out of the mountains. So remember Allah's bounties and do not act wickedly on the earth causing corruption.
The elite of his people who were arrogant said to those who were abased, to those among them who had faith, Do you know that Saleh has been sent by his Lord? They said, We indeed believe in what he has been sent with. Those who were arrogant said, We indeed disbelieve in what you have believed. So they hamstrung the she-camel and defied the command of their Lord. And they said, O Saleh, bring us what you threaten us with, if you are one of the apostles. So the earthquake seized them, and they lay lifeless, prostrate in their homes. So he abandoned them to their fate and said, O my people, certainly I communicated to you the message of my Lord, and I was your well-wisher, but you did not like well-wishers. And Lot, when he said to his people, What, do you commit an outrage none in the world ever committed before you? Indeed, you come to men with desire instead of women. Rather, you are a profligate lot. But the only answer of his people was that they said, Expel them from your town. They are indeed a puritanical lot. So we delivered him and his family except his wife. She was one of those who remained behind. Then we poured down upon them a rain of stones. So observe how was the fate of the guilty. And to the people of Midian, Shu'aib their brother, he said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God besides him. There has certainly come to you a manifest proof from your Lord. Observe fully the measure and the balance, and do not cheat the people of their goods, and do not cause corruption on the earth after its restoration. That is better for you if you are faithful. And do not lie in wait on every road to threaten and bar from the way of Allah those who have faith in him, seeking to make it crooked. And remember when you were few, and he multiplied you, and observe how was the fate of the agents of corruption. If a group of you have believed in what I have been sent with, and a group have not believed, be patient until Allah judges between us, and he is the best of judges. The elite of his people who were arrogant said, O Shu'aib, we will surely expel you and the faithful who are with you from our town, or else you shall revert to our creed. He said, What? Even if we should be unwilling? We would be fabricating a lie against Allah should we revert to your creed after Allah had delivered us from it. It does not behoove us to return to it unless Allah our Lord should wish so. Our Lord embraces all things in His knowledge. In Allah we have put our trust. Our Lord, judge justly between us and our people, and you are the best of judges. The elite of his people who were faithless said, If you follow Shu'aib, you will indeed be losers. So the earthquake seized them, and they lay lifeless prostrate in their homes. Those who impugned Shu'aib became as if they had never lived there. Those who impugned Shu'aib were themselves the losers. So he abandoned them to their faith and said, O my people, certainly I communicated to you the messages of my Lord, and I was your well-wisher, so how should I grieve for a faithless lot? We did not send a prophet to any town without visiting its people with stress and distress, so that they might entreat for Allah's forgiveness. Then we changed the ill conditions to good, until they multiplied in numbers and said, Adversity and ease befell our fathers too. Then we seized them suddenly while they were unaware. If the people of the towns had been faithful and God-wary, we would have opened to them blessings from the heaven and the earth. But they denied, so we seized them because of what they used to earn. Do the people of the towns feel secure from our punishment overtaking them at night while they are asleep? Do the people of the towns feel secure from our punishment overtaking them at midday while they are playing around? Do they feel secure from Allah's devising? No one feels secure from Allah's devising except the people who are losers. Does it not dawn upon those who inherited the earth after its former inhabitants that if we wish, we will punish them for their sins and set a seal on their hearts so they would not hear? These are the towns, some of whose accounts we recount to you. Their apostles certainly brought them manifest proofs, but they were not the ones to believe in what they had denied earlier. Thus does Allah put a seal on the hearts of the faithless. We did not find in most of them any loyalty to covenants. Indeed, we found most of them to be transgressors. Then after them, we sent Moses with our signs to Pharaoh and his elite, but they wronged them. So observe how was the fate of the agents of corruption. And Moses said, O Pharaoh, I am indeed an apostle from the Lord of all the world.